This project that we're working on is focused on materials that can be used for sensing, decontamination, and personal protection against chemical warfare agents. So this project is funded in part by the Department of Defense, and we are focused on looking at materials that are currently used in filtration materials for gas masks, and we're trying to understand better how the materials that are currently used work.
The current gas mask filtration material is a porous carbon, kind of like a water filter that you would have at home. And inside this black powdery carbon, there are different metal oxides. And the metal oxides are thought to be the really key absorption material. We use something called X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy. We shine X-rays on metal oxides, and then electrons come out. And these electrons hold information about the atoms that they came from, whether it was carbon, a metal, oxygen, and then it also tells about the chemical state. And this, in turn, gives us information on how the chemical warfare agent simulant decomposed.
There are three different applications for these kinds of materials. You want to be able to sense agents, you want to be able to protect people against the agents, and you want to be able to decontaminate places that have already been exposed to the agents. If we find a material that's really great at any one of these particular aims, then that could be applied in the real world to help protect either soldiers in the field or first responders in emergency situations who need to go in and provide medical care to civilians or other people who have been exposed.
My sister-in-law is in the Air Force, and when she gets deployed, she gets a gas mask. And the technology in the gas mask was developed during World War I, when people were using mustard gas and chlorine gas. And this is a different type of chemical compound than what people are using as chemical warfare agents today. And while the gas masks do work, they weren't built for that, and maybe there's something better. I want to be able to tell my sister-in-law how well her gas mask works when she's deployed and under what conditions.